Hi students, my name is Ritesh Narashed. I am from Annavara. So last class we discussed about a topic from 10th standard, that is arithmetic progression. In arithmetic progression, we already discussed about what is meant by arithmetic progression and what is the standard form of arithmetic progression. Also, we discussed about nth term of an arithmetic progression, and last class we discussed about the sum of n terms of an arithmetic progression. In that, we already discussed about what is the formula for finding sum of n terms of arithmetic progression. Also, we discussed about some of the problems. So, let us move ahead to the same topic. So, here we have to move to the next problem. Yes. So, look at this problem. So, find the sum of first 1000 positive integers. So, it looks like similar problem that already we did in the last class. That is, sum of first n positive integers. So that's why here we can find the solution in the two ways. That is, there are two formula for finding this type of problem. That is, one is the common formula for finding sum of n terms of a positive integer. That is, Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Another one is the particularly mentioned for this type of problem. Particularly we find out for this type of problem. That is, sum of first n positive integers. Here the value of n is equal to 1000. The formula for finding this type of problem is Sn is equal to n into n plus 1 by 2. We already found out in the last problem. So, here we can use both the formula. From both the formula we can get the correct answer. But here, in this case, we can use the standard formula of finding the sum of n terms of arithmetic progression. That is, Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d here. So, firstly we have to write the arithmetic progression. What is the arithmetic progression here? So, that is, so I will write in a summation form. That is, s is equal to 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus so on up to 1000. That means, here we have to add all those terms up to 1000. It is very very difficult. It is very very difficult to add all the terms. From the formula of finding the sum of n terms of arithmetic progression, it is very very easy to calculate. Here the value of n is 1000. So firstly we have to write all the given terms. That is, a equal to 1. That is first term. The first term of arithmetic progression, a is equal to 1. So we can directly, by the observation only, we can identify the first term, a is equal to 1. Then we have to write common difference, d is equal to, so how can we find out the d? So here we have to subtract 1 from 2, first term from the second term. So that's why here we can take 2 minus 1 is equal to 1. So here consecutive positive integer means the common difference will be 1 only. So, we can directly identify. Yes, then what is the value of n? So, then we have to write n. N is 1000 because there are 1000 terms are there, we have to add. So, n is equal to 1000. Then we have to find out S1000 is equal to what? So, S1000 we have to calculate. How can we calculate that one? From the formula for finding the sum of n terms of arithmetic progression, that is Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Then we have to insert all the values, all the known values into this equation, this formula. So after that we have to solve, and then we can get the value of sum of first 1000 positive integers. Yes. So S1000. Equal to, substitute the value of n here, value of n is equal to 1000. Yes, 1000 divided by 2. Then 2 into a, that means value of a is 1. So that means here 2 into 1 it is plus. What's the value of n here? It's 1000. So substitute 1000 minus 1 into, what's the value of d here? D is 1 here. Yes. Then, so here, 1000 by 2 it is 500. So, half of the value of 1000 is 500 into 2 plus, it is 999. Yes. So then 2 plus 999 is 1001 it is. That is 500 into 1001. So here S 1000. Yes. Here I will write the next part. That is S 1000 is equal to 500 into 1001. 500 into 1001 it is. So here 500 and then here it is 500. Yes. So this is the answer for the sum of 1000 positive integers. The first 1000 positive integers, that is the sum of first 1000 positive integers. 1000 positive integers is 500 like that. So here 500 is the sum of first 1000 positive integers. So let us move on to the next problem. Yes. The next problem tells us that how many terms of an AP? AP is nothing but it's a short form of arithmetic progression. So how many terms of an arithmetic progression? That is 24, 21, 18. Here it is arithmetic progression is given. So on must be taken so that the sum is 17. That means, so after some term, that means here in this arithmetic progression we can take some of the terms here. So that means here n value is unknown. So the value of sum of that n terms is 78. So we know the SN value, the value of SN we know here, so 78, and the value of A is given here, and the common difference also we can take here, but the value of n is unknown. That means we have to take some of the terms from this series, their sum is 78. So that means here we have to find out the value of n. So from the n value we can identify so that the n number of terms, the sum of some number of terms, then when we add those terms we get 78. So we have to find out the value of n here. So firstly what we have to do, we have to write the arithmetic progression first. So firstly we have to write the progression, that is 24, 21, 18 and so on. So from the progression we can write the value of A and value of T. So what is the value of A here? Value of A is 24. Then what is the value of D here? D is we have to subtract the first term from the second term. That is 21 minus 24 is equal to minus 3. Yes, the common difference can be negative. Then, so next term n. We don't know the value of n, that's why it's a question mark. So then we have the value of Sn, it is 78. From the known things, we can insert the known values into the formula for finding the n term, sum of n terms of a arithmetic progression. So what is the formula for finding the sum of n terms of arithmetic progression? That is Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into b. So here it is, the half the problem is over. That is, so for when you are writing the value of A, value of D, value of n, Sn. That means, so here we have the three unknown known values. So only one unknown value means, so we can find out from the formula. So just insert it and solve, then we can get the value of n. So here we have to insert all the values. That is Sn is equal to, what's the value of n? We don't know. Just remain as it is, n by 2 into 2a. Here 2 into a, what's the value of a? 24. That is 2 into 24 plus, what's the value of n? We don't know. So remain as it is, n minus 1
value of d? Value of d is minus 3 here. Yes. So then we have to solve this one. So Sn is equal to, so I will transpose this 2 to the LHS side. It becomes 2 into Sn. So is equal to n into here 2 into 24, 48. 48 plus n minus 1, that is I will multiply minus 3 into this bracket, that it becomes minus 3 into n minus 3n, so that is minus 3 into plus n minus into plus minus minus 3n minus 3n into plus minus 3n only. So minus 3n, then here it is minus 3 into minus 1, it is plus 3, plus into plus plus only plus 3. Then we know the value of Sn. Sn is equal to 78. Just substitute it. So 2 into 78 is equal to, so here I will just take n into this bracket, inside in the bracket. Before that we have to add 48 and 3. So that is n into, so here minus 3n, then 48 plus 3, it is 51, plus 51. Yes. Then we have to multiply n into this bracket. So I will take here. Yes. So 2 into 78. What happens 2 into 78? So it is 156. 156 is equal to n into minus 3n. What happens here? N into minus 3n means n into n, n square minus 3n square. Minus 3n square. Then here it is 51. 51 into n. 51n. Plus 51n. Then transpose all the terms, all these RHS terms to the LHS. So minus 3n square becomes plus 3n square. Plus 3n square. Then plus 51n becomes minus 51n. Minus 51n. Then it remains as it is. 156 is equal to 0. So just observe here, it's in the form of quadratic equation. We already discussed in the last chapter, that is, so there are many methods are there. One is factorization method is there, and completing square method is there, and quadratic formula method is there. From those three form, so we can solve out this quadratic equation. So we can find out the value of n here. So firstly we have to divide whole equation by 3, because all are the multiples of 3. All are multiples of 3. So that's why we can, when we divide, so we can simplify this quadratic equation. So firstly we have to multiply with 3. Divide throughout by 3. Divide throughout equation by 3 here. So what happens here? It becomes n square minus, so here what happens? So 17n, then plus, so here 52 is equal to 0. So it becomes a quadratic equation. We can use any method of solving quadratic equation, whether it is factorization, whether it is completing square or quadratic formula. You can use any one of these methods. So here better we have to take factorization first. Firstly we have to check factorization. So here firstly we have to multiply a and c, the coefficient of n square and the constant term. So what happens here? 52. So here firstly find out the factors. What are the factors of 52? 1 and 52. So we can get 52. Then 2 and 26. We have 52 when we are multiplying 2 and 26. We have 52. Another from 3, it is not. So here then when we are taking the 4, 4 into 13, it is possible. So these three are the factors. So let us split the middle term, whether it is possible or not. That is 1 and 52, 53. That is neglected. Then here 2 and 26,
it's not possible. So 2 and 26 means whether 24 is possible and 28 is possible. Here 4 and 13 means here it is possible to split 17 and the here from these two factors we can split the middle term. So how can we? So here plus is there, here it is minus is there. So the term we can add those two factors. The term we got when we add 4 and 13. So that's why we have to take minus and minus. Yes. So like this we have to split the middle term. That is after that we have to split n square minus 4n minus 13n plus 52 is equal to 0. Then so from those two terms n is common here. Then we have to take out n from those two terms. N into n minus 4. Then minus. Minus 13 common here. So take out minus 13. Here it becomes n minus 4 is equal to 0. Then from these two terms n minus 4 is common here. So take out n minus 4. N minus 4 into n minus 13. Here it remains n, here it remains minus 13. So it converted into the form of factorization. That is, so we have factors n minus 4 and n minus 13 of this quadratic equation. So then we have to equate separately is equal to 0. That is, n minus 4 is equal to 0 and n minus 13 is equal to 0. Then n is equal to 4. And n is equal to 13. Yes. So there are two n values are there. That means n is equal to 4 and n is equal to 13. So by observation we can identify what is the right value. That is here 24 is there, 21 is there, 18 is there. So when we add these 63 we have, it is available. So that means when we add 15, the next term, so we can get 78. So that's why when we add four terms of this arithmetic progression, we can easily get the 78. That means here n is equal to is an incorrect option for us, because when we add 13 numbers means it is higher than 17. So that's why we have to neglect that n is equal to 3. So we can take n is equal to 4 only. So n is equal to 4 is the right value for this problem. So let us conclude this problem. Yes. So when we add 4 terms of this arithmetic progression we get 78. Therefore, the n is equal to 4. So, n is equal to 4 only. So, we can find out the value of n from the formula for finding the sum of n terms of arithmetic progression. So, let us move on to the next. So this is the last type of problems in this chapter. So the problem tells us that find the sum of first 24 terms of the list of numbers is given by n is equal to 3 plus 2n. So if there is no any the first term, there is no any progression, there is no any common difference, there is no any term that is it is a sum of the, this is the sum. So here only the given is 24 terms and the n value. So that means the nth term, that is n is equal to 3 plus 2n. It is in the form of equation. So here we have to find the way of finding arithmetic progression. When the arithmetic progression is obtained means we can easily find out the sum of first 24 terms. So how can we find out the progression here? So just observe here n is equal to 3 plus 2n. So that means the arithmetic progression, commonly the standard form of arithmetic progression, we have taken it as a1 plus a1, a2, a3 like that. That means in a1 the n value is 1. In A2, the n value is 2. In A3, n value is 3. A4, n value is 4. So, like that, here we have to substitute the value of n is equal to 1, n is equal to 2, n is equal to 3, n is equal to 4. Into this equation, we can easily find out the value of first value, second value, third value. Then we have to obtain the arithmetic progression. So, how can we find out that one? So, firstly, we have to insert the value of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, like that, into this equation. Let's substitute when n is equal to 1. What happens when n is equal to 1? When we substitute the value of n into this equation, we get some value. That value is the first term of the arithmetic progression. That is, a1 is equal to 3 plus 2 into 1, it is equal to 3 plus 2 is equal to 5. It is a1. The first term we got. Then, we have to find out the second term by inserting the value of n is equal to 2. That is, when n is equal to 2, what happens here? a2 is equal to 3 plus 2 into 2 is equal to 3 plus 4 is equal to 7. Then, when n is equal to 3, a3 is equal to 3 plus 2 into 3 is equal to 3 plus 6 is equal to 9, and so on. We can find out by inserting the value of n is equal to 3. So, we can extend up to some number of terms. So, here it is enough to find three values, because when we got the three values means we have the clear cut idea about the common difference, whether it is in the arithmetic progression or not. So, after this we have to find, we have to write the arithmetic progression. So, here first value is 5. So, from the first value we have to write in the first place. Then, second value is 7. And the third value is 9. So, here it is the difference between 2 is that. So, that means 5, 7, 9. Between those two, those numbers, 2 is difference is there. That means the common difference is 2. We can directly identify what term is there only. So, there are many values. So, the progression is continuous like this. Then, we have to write the known terms. That is, what is the known term here? A is equal to 5. Then, what is the common difference? D is equal to 7 minus 5 is equal to 2, it is D. Then we want n value and we want Sn value. What is the known term here? 24 terms. That means n is equal to 24. N is equal to 24. Then we have to find out the Sn. That is S24. We can directly write it as S24 here. Yes. This is S24. So, how can we find out the value of S24 from the formula for finding the sum of n terms of arithmetic progression? That is, Sn is equal to n by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Yes. So, from this formula we can easily calculate the value of S24. That is, S24 is equal to, it is 20. N is equal to 24 divided by 2 and 2 into A. What is the value of A here? 5. So, 2 into 5 plus N minus 1. What is N here? 24. That is 24 minus 1 into, what is the value of D? It is 2. Then simplify. That is equal to 12 into 2 into 5, 10. 10 plus 24 minus 1 is equal to 23 into 2 is equal to, then 12 into 10 plus 23 into 2. What happens here? 23 is 46 is equal to 12 into 10 plus 46, it is 56. So, 67. So 672. That is S24 is equal to 672. We got the answer 672 here. So that means the sum of 24 terms of this arithmetic progression is 672 years. So here we got the solution for this problem. So this is the last problem. So I will conclude this chapter here. So those who are watching this video for the first time, please subscribe our channel and don't forget to press the bell icon. So there are many sort of problems are there. You have to take in the exercise and you have to solve by using the formula for finding sum of n terms of arithmetic progression. So thank you one and all. Be safe and stay home.